Take this down. Then I want it sealed until you receive further orders. Miss Thorne. You supplied me with the means to secure London's future. The city thanks you. The Order thanks you. I thank you. But the Shroud can only be worn by one. Therefore, I hereby dissolve this partnership. I promise to endow you with an income into your old age. That is the most I can do. May the Father of Understanding guide you. Yes, what is it?
Miss Thorne, sir.
What of her?
I'm sorry, sir. She is dead.
And the key? Where is the key?
There was no key found on her body, sir.
The Shroud will be mine, even if I have to raise hellfire to do it. Burn the letter.
Well, what say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abeline family's robust constitution.
Two pennies robbing the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to seal it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault.
See the inner workings of this thrilling marvel of commerce. face me if you dare.
Fancy. Fitting for Twopenny's tomb.
To count it as long as you live. Clumsiness.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Faster!
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their worth.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
You're nothing to me!
Murder! Murder!
Thank goodness, the police! We're saved!
Arrest them all for robbing the people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice.
The currency, a laughingstock. Inflation out of control, twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffoon Disraeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however, I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I'd wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other, when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again! Understood? You may see yourself out.
A letter. For me?
Dear Mr. Starrick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Starrick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie. Nearly. A letter. For me? A letter. For me?
Oh, Mignonette, your qualities surpass your charms.
I'm not entirely sure that's meant as a compliment. Love in a Mist. That's a pretty name.
Alternatively called Devil in a Bush.
Narcissus. Self-love. I should buy a bouquet for Jacob.
Most unkind, Miss Fry.
As amusing as all this is, I really should be getting back to work. If you need me...
I'll send a bouquet.
Of irises?
A message. Indeed.
You're looking in fine fettle, Jacob.
A letter. For me?
I thought I'd stop by for a visit.
You would just calm yourself.
What has happened?
Not here.
Your brother.
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Twopenny's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation. Riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
It would certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Twopenny's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help.
No more exploitation! No more slave wages!
Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent nearby. Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Abilene.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Abilene.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
The counterfeiters.
She can't do too much good.
Questions.
Heard about the rioting at the bank?
They can riot all they like. We won't be giving back those plates.
What difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on him.
From the strangest thing I've
Since
seen
we've got
here.
The printing plates, it's all real cash.
What are you doing?
Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting.
Nothing to do with us.
All right, miss. You feeling fine?
I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. He acts in haste and repents not at all.
You think she has some of these?
Easy, girl.
Keep your eyes open. Anyone could be trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir.
What is she doing? Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
Absolutely, sir.
Is that down me, Dr. People?
Looks like it's been a killing.
Now to sneak these back into the bank. Let's do this the easy way. There, as if they were never taken.
Thank you.
then.
London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.
Thank you.
Please tell me again where we are going.
I found a letter from the Prince Consort among Lucy Thorne's research, marked with the same insignia as your key, dated 1847.
1847.
The same year the Prince began renovations to Buckingham Palace.
You think he added a vault for the Shroud?
And since there is no map of the palace with the room marked Secret Vault...
Your Highness, may I present Miss Evie Fry. Miss Fry, Maharaja Duleep Singh.
A pleasure, Your Highness.
My friend, the plans you asked for have been removed.
Removed? By whom?
Crawford Starrick, or someone employed by him. Yes, I thought you might recognize the name. I know where they are, but it is heavily guarded.
That part will not be a problem.
I thought not.
We're going to need a plan.
I can provide a distraction for the guards while you find a safe way inside.
Oh. Really?
For you, Evie? Certainly.
Well, once I'm inside, I'll find someone who knows where the papers are stored.
And we will meet back on the train.
Be careful. That's not them. What's the plan?
When you give the signal, I'll draw the guards into a fight and then use a smoke bomb to get away.
And I'll take advantage of the confusion. Ready?
Absolutely.
anything. Show me.
I'll shut your mouth right quick.
He's over there.
I'll stop your chatter.
Nothing here. No. Looks like I have to ask someone where the plans are.
I don't know where they've taken him.
Taken who?
The man, dressed like you. The guards dragged him off.
Henry, the plans you stole, where are they?
I don't know anything about that.
The plans, the mission. You're some of Clara's children.
They took Mr. Henry. We couldn't stop them.
I bit one of them good, though.
They dragged him off in a red carriage.
They won't get far, though.
one wheel looked like it was about ready to fall off. You can see the cart tracks. It looks all wobbly-like.
Been run off the road. They must be driving quickly. Come on. They're knocking people over, too. And destruction of public property. I must be on the right track.
Here now. Are you well?
Ready for a round.
There you go.
That must be the carriage. Found you. Now to find Henry.
I will go out of my way to involve myself in your life.
I don't know anything about the carriage, but there's been some strange happenings around here today. All kinds of unsavory types wandering around.
Alert!
I've offered mine to take you home and feed you to me dogs. You won't be stirring up no more trouble.
Strange man. Mad as a march here.
Yeah, I saw them dragging someone out of the carriage after the wheel fell off. I see he was
killed. You won't be stirring.
Sleep it off.
I don't bloody believe it.
The rock star is here!